are the first man in history to win 5 world titles. I haven't yet received that yet. People know me as being the first man in history to win 5 world titles, but to get that, I mean, I guess that big fame, that big glory, that big reception, I haven't yet received that yet.
And we are live at beautiful...
...factor in the fight, but not as much as people make out. Here comes Tommy Hearns looking extremely serious and determined, and with a very flashy-looking space cadet suit. What is that? He looks intense.
Well, they got a... Well, I don't think they're any threat to MC Hammer. But nonetheless, Thomas Hearns coming down, and Alex Shearer is at his side, his trainer now. And I think we must address this point at this time, Ferdy, the fact that Thomas Hearns, for the first time in a real big fight, will not be with Emmanuel Stewart in his corner tonight. Could that be a factor?
It certainly could, but we'll wait and see. The interesting thing is Emmanuel, who is a dear friend of mine and a great gentleman, picks Tommy Hearns to win today, saying that Virgil Hill is too amateurish for the talents of a finished professional fighter like Tommy Hearns. So we will see. As the fight progresses, we'll be able to determine that. But once the bell sounds, it's really going to be up to Tommy Hearns, and it's going to be up to Virgil Hill, and the corners really won't make that much difference at that time.
That is Alex Shearer, the chief trainer now for Thomas Hearns, directly behind him, just off of his right shoulder there. You've got a good shot of him there. Alex Shearer, who was with the Kronk organization for a long time and has known Thomas for years.
And he's got his brother with him right behind him. You see Lloyd Wells, who was with part of the Muhammad Ali entourage for so many years. He's surrounded by good professional people right now, people that know the boxing game and know Tommy Hearns very well. And so this is kind of one of those nights of truth for Tommy Hearns. It's an exciting night for him. Either goes on to further fame, which he seems to think is eluding him, or he quietly drifts off into the Las Vegas Knights.
Thomas, as you saw in that profile, has done a lot for the USO. He visited the troops in Saudi Arabia. After this fight, win or lose, he's going to travel to Washington, D.C. to join President Bush, General Colin Powell, and General Norman Schwarzkopf for an entire day devoted to welcoming home the U.S. troops who participated in the Gulf. It'll be a Washington, D.C. event. That's on June 8th, so that's just next week. And then on June 10th, Thomas is going to travel to New York for another huge parade and celebration. He'll ride the only float in the parade with other celebrities and entertainers who have supported the USO for the past 50 years. And now coming into the ring, Thomas Hitman Hearns. One thing that's going to happen tonight, there will not be large... At least that's what they say. They're going to try and limit the number of people who get into this ring, 30 after the fight, to prevent the kind of ugly incident that occurred at the end of the Ruddock Tyson fight.
Good luck, champ. With your blood. Good luck.
Mills Lane, referee, very competent referee.
He's a federal judge. He's a federal judge and extremely competent prosecuting attorney for a long time. And an admirable man in boxing, because this kind of guys who like to track and box, very active. Although he had one bad night with Tommy Hearns, where Tommy got hit very hard by Kinson and rattled him so much he had to hold on, and he just could not separate them. And here comes Virgil Hill, the champion.
And Virgil will carry the North Dakota flag, as he always does, into the ring with him. The hero of North Dakota. He's got a biography called Champ that was printed up in North Dakota. It's a hot seller in North Dakota. And last week at a press conference, he presented a copy of it to Thomas Hearns, and he inscribed in it, "Good luck in your retirement. Best wishes, Virgil Hill."
Oh, is a gentleman a master of psychological warfare.
They're showing this fight tonight on closed circuit television at 39 different locations in North Dakota, and they're all expected to sell out. But a lot of fans from North Dakota have made it here to Las Vegas to cheer Virgil Hill on. They were present at the weigh-in yesterday.
They're a noisy bunch, I'll say that. They take their boxing seriously in North Dakota.
The light heavyweight champion of the world has yet to lose a fight. I wonder how he is feeling coming down that aisle under this atmosphere and these kind of conditions, really for the first time.
Well, there's a lot of relief in it, I'll tell you that. When it's finally time to walk down that aisle and you come down, it's relief mingled with apprehension, but you're finally getting it on.
Here's the champion. Freddie Roach's trainer, very competent trainer, was an entertaining fighter to watch. Virgil with the North Dakota flag. Look who's in there with him. The mayor of Bismarck, North Dakota.
You got to get your votes wherever you can find them.
All right. Thomas Hearns is coming up in weight class for this fight. He has been, of course, a middleweight champ. He was light heavyweight champ once before, but he comes up. We take a look at the tail of the tape, and Hearns is still taller as he has been over most of his opponents. Just a pound between the two in the weight. The most interesting and perhaps the most significant stat there that you're looking at, the age, 32 to 27. And now as we take a look at the rules for this WBA light heavyweight title fight, three judges, of course, 10-point must system, no standing eight. The three knockdown rule is in effect, and you can only be saved by the bell in the last round. So this is it. Thomas...
Thank you very much, Jeffrey Osborne. Thank you to the U.S. Marine Corps Color Guard. Ladies and gentlemen in attendance and sports fans joining us around the world, welcome to the home of champions, Caesar's Palace in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, as Forum Boxing Incorporated, in association with Caesar's Palace, present our featured bout, the WBA Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. This bout is sanctioned by the World Boxing Association, President Gilberto Mendoza, Supervisor Murray Sleep, along with the Nevada State Athletic Commission, Chairman James Nave, Commissioners Luther Mack, Dr. Elias Ganem, Bruce Lane, Nat Caraselli. The Executive Director is Chuck Minker. Presenting the officials as appointed, physicians at ringside, Dr. Flip Homansky, Dr. James Game, Dr. Al Campana. The timekeeper at the bell is Mike LaSella. Keeping count of the knockdowns, Jane Broadfoot. Introducing the judges at ringside, we have Chuck Jumpa, Art Lurie, and Jerry Roth. And the referee in charge of this bout, he will be giving instructions after the introductions, Mills Lane. All right, fans, here we go. This is it. The fight for respect, the bout you've all been waiting for. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first the challenger. On my left, fighting out of the red corner. He enters the ring with turquoise trunks and gold trim. Hailing from Detroit, Michigan, now representing the VIP Boxing Club in Venice, California. His weight, already 174 pounds. His outstanding record, 49 victories, 3 defeats, 1 draw with 40 big wins by way of knockout. Welcome the legendary 5-time world champion, the one and only Thomas Hitman Hearns. And his opponent across the ring is the defending champion, fighting out of the blue corner. Entering the ring with black trunks, silver trim, and hailing from Bismarck, North Dakota. His weight is already 173 pounds. His outstanding record, 30 wins, no losses, with 18 wins by way of knockout. Introducing the WBA light heavyweight champion, the pride of North Dakota, the undefeated Virgil Quicksilver Hill.
All right, come on, let's go. All right. Okay, now. All right, both of you gentlemen have had your instructions in this room already. Expect a clean fight, protect yourself at all times. Any questions from the challenger?
No questions whatsoever.
Any questions from the champion? Let's get it on!
But if you're a boxing fan, you've got to love Mills Lane's instructions.
Yeah, the little motion by Hearns was a little chilling, too. It's become a big production, these introductions. But when you got a referee like Mills Lane, you find a judge is sentencing you to start fighting from the bell. I mean, he's challenging you, and your heart is beating, and here comes the bell to start the fight.
All right, I think we know what to expect in terms of style from Hitman Hearns, but how will Virgil Hill approach this bout? Will he try to bomb with Hearns early, or will he be his usual boxing self?
Hearns looking bigger right off the bat. You look at a man that's physically bigger, more imposing than the champion, Virgil Hill, who seems skinny up top compared to Thomas.
Thomas moving forward, and Virgil, the lateral movement as we expected.
Don't forget, while everybody talks about cannons and sharpshooting, Hearns was an excellent boxer most of his career. When he wants to, he can box.
Well, I think that's been borne out on several occasions, Ferdy. He can outbox a master boxer. He did it to Wilfred Benitez. He did it to Sugar Ray Leonard.
Absolutely. In the first fight, he turned from slugger to boxer and was winning the fight.
So Hearns does have that ability to adjust depending upon how a fight is going. Trying to stick that long left jab of his out and set it up for one of the most dangerous weapons in probably boxing's history, the hitman's right hand. Just a combination of jabs, two jabs to the head, and then he went down to the body with it.
Virgil testing the water, seeing if his reflexes really are faster than Tommy's. So far, just tentative, he's just putting it out there, but he's been landing.
Virgil Hill, as we showed you on our pre-fight show this evening, will at times jab to the body, and he's done that a couple of times already in this first round. There it is again. Hearns looks like he's trying to get loose.
He's trying to get loose. It's what happens to an older fighter when you reflex. He saw the opening, but it didn't land. He saw that he laid out the left hand. He dropped the right hand, but he was too slow. He's loose, trying to loosen his arms like saying, hey, this isn't me. I punch faster than this. And it'll take him a round or two to warm up, too. Tommy will not start off fast. He'll start off, warm up to his task. Such a master boxer, he'll figure out Virgil. Virgil Hill must continue to keep his presence of mind, certainly trying to avoid the powerful right hand of Tommy Hearns.
Virgil Hill opened up when this fight was announced as a 4-1 favorite over Thomas Hearns, but the fight odds closed at about 2.5-1, with Virgil Hill remaining the favorite. So Hearns in a real underdog role. Each man trying to establish the jab here in the first round.
Very tentative round. Not hard combat here, but sort of a feeling out round, and certainly Virgil testing the water over and over. Can I get in there? Can I get in there with impunity? Can I punch and not be hit? The crowd starting to come up from nervous tension.
But remember, Virgil Hill has said he feels he needs an impressive victory, a smashing victory tonight over Thomas Hearns. But in the first round, he boxed as usual.
Okay, perfect.
Let's listen to Alex Shearer now.
Deep breath. Okay, lean your head back. Get a little closer to him.
Mm-hmm.
Just get a little bit closer to him and busy with your left hand. When the man tries to jab to your body, right hand down the pike and left hook behind it. Another thing, too, he's jabbing and trying to hook. Don't pull back. Right
now, here's Freddie Roach.
All night. You best be right?
So that pain's stopping when you're busy.
See, the pain is getting tight already. Keep that quick jab going. All right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Beautiful run. Keep frustrating this guy. All right?
Freaking down.
All right?
Freddie Roach saying, you're frustrating him. Beautiful round. Keep jabbing. Keep moving. Keep being faster. All good instructions.
They felt that, Freddie said that he felt that Hearns was tight. Do you agree with that assessment?
Yes, because you saw him shake himself out. You saw him, he's too knotted up. You saw physical evidence of it. He's tight in that he can't get that jab off as fast as Hill. That figures to be all night.
And watching the two of them train, it did appear as though Virgil Hill was a noticeably quicker fighter than Thomas Hearns during training.
Tommy's stepping up the action right now, trying to trade jabs with Hill. Hill keeping that distance. certainly no desire on Hill's part to mix it up with Tommy Hearns. So far in this fight, he has fought as he has fought his other fights, with a great deal of caution, using brilliant boxing tactics, hitting and not getting hit in return. An almost perfect way to fight if warranted.
Virgil Hill has really been serious, Ferdy, about this respect thing. He felt that this was being turned into the Thomas Hearns show, and he was a little bit upset about that. The fact that the one press conference, for example, Hill was introduced first as a champion before Hearns, that award was presented to Hearns at another press conference he was at. And he said, hey, this isn't the Thomas Hearns show. I'm the guy with the title.
Well, here's where to solve it, right in the ring. Nothing happening right now. Both men missing. Both men extremely tight in stamina.
Hill so far has been a one-handed fighter in this fight.
But he usually is. He usually punches, inverted left-hander, punches jab, and then turns him over into hooks.
There's the first right hand tried by Thomas Hearns, and it missed. Hill with a good, quick defensive move to get away with it, but that's the first time that Hearns showed the ball. Now he goes in with a left hook. Hearns kind of nodded at him and said, yeah, that was a pretty good one, Thomas. But not bothered by it, really.
Well, the crowd expecting instant results from punches from Hearns will roar when something hard comes, but it remains to be seen how Hill takes those hard punches.
Each man has got plenty of support here tonight. As I look at Mike Tyson in the middle of your screen, sitting there right between the two fighters, he's a real student of boxing. And look at, he is intense in studying those two guys.
He is a student of boxing, and he's very knowledgeable about it. He's a reader, which most people don't understand. He reads books about it and other things. He's a surprising man.
Hearns has shown the right hand in this round. Hill still trying to utilize just the left. There's that snake-like jab of Virgil Hill. Goes to the body with it, comes back up to the head with it. But it's all jabbing from Virgil Hill so far. Thomas, a little nod of respect to the champion, Virgil Hill. You know, Hearns, as we mentioned, went to the Persian Gulf during the crisis for the USO. Question now, will he continue to work with the USO and our troops come future years? Let's find out from Thomas.
Yes, indeed. I definitely stand plan to continue work with the USO. Matter of fact, I'm trying to put together a fund for the USO to help the USO to make it possible for different types of celebrities to go visit our troops wherever they are, all over the world, wherever they may be, send someone to visit them, to let them know that we care.
That's Thomas Hearns, and for this USO fund, you can call for information. You can write to 601 Indiana Avenue Northwest in Washington, D.C. at 2004.
You're beginning to see a tentative look in the eyes of Virgil Hill. He certainly didn't fight with a lot of confidence in that round. Once he felt the sting of Tommy's punches, I thought Tommy won that round, evening out one round apiece.
Well, both Virgil Hill and Freddie Roach have said that they felt that Thomas was on the downside of his career. And there were some who felt that maybe Hill would try to come out and bomb with Thomas. Did you think so, Ferdy?
No, I didn't think so. Based on what he's done in his career, you always tend to do what you've done to win. There's no reason to go in the other guy's camp and fight his fight. I would say that what he wants is to get Tommy tired, so he's willing to while away these rounds and boredom before things get busy. Tommy just playing games.
Yeah, Hearns is starting to cook now. He's getting confident. Hearns is beginning to get more confident with each second.
He certainly has a look of confidence in him. He has a look of snapping the jab. He wanted, and he's closing the distance between he and Hill. Amazed that Hill isn't bouncing back away from that. He is standing there straight in front of him, not giving him angles, not giving him anything.
Virgil Hill is beginning to develop a bruise under his right eye. He's already eaten several of those jabs from Thomas Hearns.
And not that many. It's just that they're hard. I mean, Tommy does have a hard jab and can turn it over into a hook before you can say his name.
Something else we might note, there had been reports the last couple of weeks that Virgil Hill's hands were sore. You saw those hands. There were a number of abrasions on them, Ferdy. What was your assessment of that?
I had some calluses on each knuckle. I don't understand why that close to fight. Things got that far out of control without treating them, but you can fix that. He certainly doesn't show any difficulty like that now. He's fighting with both hands without any kind of pain.
Been a left jab round. The two just trying to out jab each other right now.
Tommy's waiting for a mistake. He's waiting for this guy to make some kind of mistake. He's all wound up like a crossbow, ready to just fling, and when he doesn't get it, he gets so tight he has to finally loosen up his muscles.
But that time, as he started to relax and try to loosen up, Hill just tagged him with a left jab. There's that jab from Thomas Hearns, and now Hill brings it right back. Look at this battle of left jabs. It's an interesting battle of jabs, each man trying to be dominant with their left hand.
Virgil faster, Hearns harder. Oh, Hearns' jab is hard. It is snapping back Virgil Hill's head. That is an attention-getting jab. And the right hand has yet to be thrown by Tommy after all those jabs.
There's a definite reddening under the right eye of Virgil Hill. He tries to come across with the right, but Hearns answers with a counter right hand.
Virgil Hill is fighting wild eyes. His eyes are wide. Tommy's are squinted. He's like ready to do battle. Ready to take this guy out.
There's a bell. Very interesting third round as we follow Virgil Hill back to his corner.
Here's Freddie Roach.
One going.
Okay.
Hi, Virgil. Here you go.
Now, Bud, I want you to feint and back this guy up with the jab. Once you get him going back, you keep him going back. You understand?
Uh-huh.
Okay? Double jab right here in the body off the side, okay?
Let's watch this jab. This is a jab that's making the difference for Hearns, because Hearns can put it in and follow with the right hand like you just saw it just in. The other look from a different angle, you can watch the power of Hearns as he comes back with the right hand. That's what he's been waiting for three rounds, and he landed it.
Drop down, hit right here. Keep it. Give him the mic.
There's Thomas looking confident.
It's a bell one.
Boy, he has been wound tighter than a drum mill for this fight. And just starting to shake out. And that was a real interesting battle of jabs in that round. And when they each finally threw the right, it was Hearns' right that got home.
You know, Hearns is the kind of fighter that doesn't look good in uninteresting fights with bad opponents. But when you give him a challenge and he gets all prepared, he's been training 6 months now. That might have tired him out. Nice punch by Virgil Hill.
Hey, he's fooled people before. Don't forget 2 years ago when people thought he was a shot fighter going in to fight Sugar Ray Leonard.
Well, today, so far, he looks like a very determined, well-conditioned fighter. He's in here for the full 12.
Good job from Hill, but then Hearns answers with a left hand himself.
The difference in these two is that Hearns has no respect for Virgil Hill's power, whereas Hill has a great deal of respect for Hearns, and that difference tells in those jabs. Hill's tentative and Hearns hard.
And that jab of Hearns still getting to work. He's landing it in the face, and Hill feels it when he lands it.
Well, they're already putting in swell in the corner to keep it from his eyes from swelling up, and they are swelling up. So something's causing it, and that something is the jab of Tommy Hearns.